Hi guys, my name is Nishil Kaushal and I'm currently working as a legal intern with Alexis & Company. And today I will talk about the term unpaid seller, and also I'll discuss about the rights of the unpaid seller against the goods and the buyer's personality. So I'll start. So basically the term unpaid seller has been defined in section 45 clause 1. According to this section, a seller is deemed to be an unpaid seller when, first, the whole of the price has not been paid or tendered, second, a bill of exchange or other negotiable instrument has been received as a conditional payment, and the condition on which it was received has not been fulfilled by reason of dishonor of the instrument or otherwise. So according to section 45 clause 2, the term seller includes not only the actual seller but also any person who is in the position of a seller, as for example an agent of the seller to whom the bill of lading has been endorsed, or a consigner or agent who has himself paid or is directly responsible for the price. So what are the rights of an unpaid seller? The rights of an unpaid seller can be explained basically in two heads, as first the rights of the unpaid seller against the goods, and the rights of the unpaid seller against the buyers personally. So basically the rights of an unpaid seller against the goods. An unpaid seller has the following rights against the goods when the property in the goods has passed to the buyer. It has the right of lien, right of stoppage of goods in transit, and right of resale. Now what is right of lien? It is described under section 47. Right of lien means the right to retain the goods until the price due in respect of them is paid or tendered. However, it is noted that the unpaid seller's lien is a possessory lien. It means the lien can be exercised only for the non-payment of the price and not for any other charges. Now, second is the right of stoppage of goods in transit. So basically, the right of stoppage of in transit means the right of stopping further transit of the goods while they are in carrier for the purpose of transmission to the buyer, resuming possession of them and retaining possession until payment or tender of the price. The right of stoppage of goods in transit can be enjoyed only when the goods are in the course of transit and before the delivery to the buyer by the carrier. On the delivery of the goods by the carrier to the buyer, the consignor loses the right of stoppage of goods in transit. Now, when can these rights be exercised? So this is presented under section 50, as an unpaid seller can exercise the right only when, first, the buyer becomes insolvent, second, the property has passed to the buyer, and third, the property is in the course of transit. However, it is noted that when the transit comes to an end, the right of stoppage cannot be exercised. Now, third comes the right of resale. The right of resale is a limited right which may be available in the following cases, as first, where the goods are of perishable nature, second, or where the unpaid seller has exercised his rights of lien or stoppage in transit, gives notice to the buyer of his intention to resale. The unpaid seller may, if the buyer does not within a reasonable time pay or tender the price or resell the goods. And third, where the seller expressively reserves a right of resale in case the buyer should make a default and on the buyer making default. Now, what are the rights of the unpaid seller against the buyer personally? The unpaid seller has the following three rights of action against the buyer personally, which are stated as, first, suit for price. This is in section 52, 55. Second is suit for damages of non-acceptance, section 56. And third is suit for special damages and interest, section 61. Now, what is suit for price? Where property in goods has passed to the buyer, or where the sale price is payable on a certain day, the seller is entitled to sue the buyer for price. Irrespective of the delivery of goods, the seller is entitled to sue when the buyer neglects or refuses to pay the price according to the terms of the contract. Now, second comes the suit for damages for non-acceptance. The seller may sue the buyer for damages where the buyer wrongfully neglects or refuses to accept and pay for the goods. And third comes suit for special damages and interest. Section 61 entitles the seller to sue the buyer for special damages. This section also entitles the unpaid seller's right to get interest at a reasonable rate on the total unpaid price of the goods sold. He is entitled from the time it was due until it is actually paid. Thank you.